Landing back in clear reality, he finds he is lying alone on the floor of a kitchen. A drone of low conversation drifts in through the open kitchen door, from what sounds like a couple of rooms away. Dud's and Ashley's voices, too far off for Scorpio to make out what they are saying. He must still be in the Blue Jay Way house. Near him is a back door, leading outside. It's closed and probably locked, but he'd be silly not to try the handle. He hauls himself up and tries it. Unlocked. It's unlocked because, as he cannot know, Ashley has left it unlocked for him. Later, she will apologise to Dud for her carelessness in doing so. Scorpio creeps outside. An alleyway on his left leads to the end of an infinity pool, with the cityscape in the distance beyond, while a path ahead leads to an open, formal garden with long rectangular ponds and fountains like a miniature Versailles, bordered by low box hedges interspersed with a topiary of tall shrubs shaped into onion domes, teardrops and twirly cones. He plumps instead for the greater concealment of a narrower pathway on his right, which he's glad to find leads him away from the house and out of visibility, along the very edge of Dud's land. Along this he flits, between two crisp white stone balustrades that stand in harsh geometric precision against the organic invasion they fend off on either side. The balusters on his right mark the furthest boundary of manicured civilization, beyond which a thorny scrub of barrel cacti and yucca falls steeply down a rock slope, croaking with hidden insect talons, while the balusters on his left forefend a lush overgrowth of ferns and magnolias, kept artificially alive with sprinklers. He reaches a narrow gate, unlocked also. Ashley's prudent preparations again, as he cannot know. Shooting hunted glances behind him, he slinks through it and finds himself back out on Blue Jay Way, some way below the main entrance to the house.